How you doing, people? Last Thursday, we started on a little bit of a journey on what we was going to do this weekend. I'm taking a little stopper to make this video to show you what we accomplished. My boy was helping me.
Hey.
We were doing some fun stuff.
I'm doing all the work. He's just telling me what to do.
Like, that's right, yeah. And we were using this poor little lathe. It's that little lathe right now is getting used to be kind of a collect all, isn't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I even got my smoking gum on it. Okay, here's what we're doing. Just for fun, because we can. And we know how. And maybe I would like to open some eyes for some of you crazy ones out there that all things are possible. I showed you that head, what we were going to do, the cylinder. We're going to cut the cylinder off and one thing and another. And you guys in the past, you've seen that little reed that I put together on a 372. Yeah, a dirt bike reed and a 372, come on, you know. Well, the design is. Okay, but we went further. We went a lot further. We got it mocked together. Right there. It's all mocked together. Boy, I tell you, this has been fun. I'm going to try to take the camera out of the mount. So when I shake you guys around, understand. Okay, here's what we got. Right here is a reed cage that was on the cylinder. We have a very short intake boot. Get the camera, see it? To the carburetor. That carburetor, the throttle linkage lines up, air cleaner is in the proper spot, everything fits. We'll get you back in the mount. All right, there we go. So everything fits. All right. We aren't sure of everything we want. I want some nice beading around here. I really do. We're going to take this area of a low top and cut it off. And we're going to fill that in so that when that goes on, it doesn't protrude. It'll be right flush. It'll be right from the surface right around. Now when we fill that in, wouldn't that be an awesome place to put the name of the chainsaw on this? Yeah, I think it would too. So, we're going to use low top. Everybody so far approves of that. Now, what I'm going to do is show you our fit. You'll get to see just a little better view. If I can grab this again without screwing it up. Where everything fits. Like I said, right there's our reed cage. Remember I told you we're going to cut a factory boot off? Yeah, aluminum throttle cable holder right here. Carb, and you see right here the, as soon as I get there, throttle cable's lining up, everything lines up. Kind of an interesting little deal here, isn't it? Here's our cylinder. We've turned and faced it. Yes, that's a Wiseco flat top. But the bearings in the saw won't hold us. We're going to use hybrid ceramics. Here's our head. The outer ring on this head that you see right here is where our copper head gasket that I have to build sits right here. That goes right in, and that locks right in there. Just perfect. In fact, earlier we had it kind of suction itself on. It's that close. These holes are going to be filled, you see. We don't need them. We're going to rebore holes that fit this. I'm using 8mm studs. We just got a thread for the saw, is all. And we're getting nuts on top. But what's really cool about this, rather than try to use a factory head, is you got a lot of meat right there. I'm going to be able to put studs in there with some really nice nuts on that that are, you know, the round-topped acorn nuts, chrome-plated ones. And that's going to be kind of neat, isn't it? I'm going to pull this apart. This is just a mock-up, guys. How many of you have already decided that this wasn't going to be no fun to run, or it's not going to work, or you love it? That's good. I'm doing this because I know how and I can. This is not as complicated as you think. It really isn't. Let me take this stuff apart here and put it away and let you just kind of look. Dirt bikes have heads, right? Don't dirt bike heads look just like that? I think they do. Yeah, I know. That's a small combustion chamber.
Where's your water jacket?
I don't need no stinking water. That's old school. It's air cold. Yeah, he brought up a good point. We should make this water cold. Wouldn't that be neat? It'd start getting heavy, wouldn't it? So he would just cut a boot off. Yeah, that's going to get a band clamp on it. It really is. We'll pull a cylinder. There's our little piston. Nice little white skull. Hand me this other little piston. Let's just talk about possibilities.
This one or this one?
Yeah, that one. Okay. We figured this out where that, as you see, that's a fairly long skirt. This piston, by the way, is a white skull. It's from Chainsaw Conservation Components. If you want to know where to get these, get them from him. He's an awful nice guy. He's an awful nice guy. But we have this little piston. That's probably the only one in the world I'll ever get. It's from Dominant from a while ago. That's 52 millimeter. With a dome. And as you see right here, that skirt is actually quite a bit shorter. Okay, real short skirt thing. I can run a dome in it, or I can run a flat top. Honestly, I think I would run nicer with a flat top using a center plug, personally. So we'll get this one right out of the way. Now, what I'm going to be able to do is, you're going to wonder, well, why? Why would you do that? Okay. For those of you who didn't see it, that's my reed cage. Goes right in there. We took the timing out of the intake. Okay. The reed controls the timing. I got the other piston. I cut that notch in. If I use this piston, I'm going to shorten these skirts. On the intake side, it doesn't even matter what I do. Exhaust side, I just need to make sure it seals up. Yep. But right here in this area, I've got to make a window that lines up with this reed cage, which I'll put this one back together. I was going to run this piston because I wasn't going to go all that crazy with this saw. Quite honestly, but I don't know if you'll be able to see this or not without a light, but yeah, you can. You see the window there? Oh, I'd rotated the wrong way. Let me get it lined back up. Right there. You can see the window in the piston. You need that. Trust me, you need that. That would have worked, but not at high RPM. It would not have worked at high RPM. That might have been a little dangerous. We are substantially raising that compression. I'll tell you that right now. We really are. This is really going to be a fun build. I have not ported it yet. We got to do the normal things. We got to cut these off right here. Probably below flush. Okay. The transfers have got to be opened up major. Okay, now, if you can get in there, because of being a center fire instead of an angle plug, I have to take my primary and secondary transfers, and I got to do some weird things with them. So, and I pride myself in being able to figure out how to do things so that you at home can do this with stuff you can buy at Walmart. Now, you've seen this advertised on TV. I'm sure you have. Otherwise, look it up. This is aluminum rod that you can weld with a propane tank. With MAP gas. Yes. So what that lets us do, without having to buy thousands of dollars worth of stuff, we're going to, you see where your transfers are. You line up right out here, and you bore a hole in each one. So you can get your Dremel tool in there. So you can work on them transfers. Yep. And then, because we do what we do, we'll show you doing that right on the channel. I will show you that. I'll explain some of the port work, why it's got to be different as we do it. Probably not going to be the only header build. I found out you can get them in anodized colors, green, red, blue, black, yellow, orange. Yeah. Well, what color do you think we ought to do? I kind of thought this one was cool, and this is going to work great. We're going to sneak up on our compression. It's a one-ring piston. We want that. Less parasitic drag, meaning two-ring has more parasitic drag. But I'm going to tell you something. A two-ring piston never oils between the rings. You get hot spots. Okay, how many of you already left a comment? Dude, you're going to get so much major heat, it's ridiculous. Good job. You got it right. We have more cooling capacity in the top than a factory one does, obviously. That's going to help. We're going to get air around between our fins still. I know you're thinking, why'd you have the lid off, you know? Would that hurt it? No, it's going to help it. It's going to dissipate heat out of the top. But the air that cools it is still going to go around the cylinder, around these areas, just like it's supposed to. Still going to do that. It has no choice. But I'll tell you, when I looked at this head, the one thing I realized, and after we get our studs in, and we get our holes bored, I'm going to take this area, and we're going to go ahead and use a forming tool and plunge cut them so they look like these, down within a safe distance of our, or we might even go further than safe. We don't know what we're doing. We can do anything we want. It's our saw, right? For cooling. All right, something I do not discuss. Local people have asked me this for years. Harv, how can you run your saw so hard and so hot, and they don't blow up? How come mine blow up stock and yours don't when you do what you do to them? I stay within realistic limits of what's possible, but I got a very good way of cooling a saw. You know where they stick, don't you? This side of the exhaust port. They can stick over here, too. But you definitely got more friction on the around the intake. Yes, you do. Because we put a reed in that, we could actually do something way cool there. What we're going to do is we're going to, unless this is the exhaust side. No, it's not the piston I'm using. Right in here and right in here. I'm going to drill a small hole, and I'm going to deburr that, of course. On the intake side, I'm going to do the same thing, a small hole on a small hole. Well, how's that going to affect things? I'll tell you exactly how. It's going to make things better. We don't want to make them worse, do we? That will give extra lubrication in those friction areas of your cylinder. And it has a cooling effect on that exhaust side, because when that air fuel mixture goes, when the piston's going down, gets shoved out them holes, okay? That puts more oil. The oil breaks out of the fuel, and it has more oil on your cylinders and your piston. And your wing, your every revolution, your ring wipes it off, and it starts off clean again. Okay, I don't know if I want to do it initially or just sneak up on it. I'm targeting 275 pounds of compression. We might go as high as 300. Yeah, I know. Well, you're never going to be able to pull a darn thing over you, bonehead. Yeah, I will. I'm going to tell you what I'm going to do. I'm not using, and I'll get this one here. I'm not using the stock decompressor. In fact, if you notice, I pretty much butchered it. Yeah, we're going to weld that up and fill that too. We're not doing that. You see where your hole is? I got to get it the right way. There it is, right there. See that right there? That's your decomp hole. From here to the top, it'll still build a little tiny bit more compression. Compression is king in some areas. Normally, I don't worry about compression in a two-stroke. Believe me, they'll build the compression that they want to run. But we're doing something a little more wild and a little more hairy with this. So, when we get done, now we're going to make an attempt to make it simple first, and then let's complicate it later. I'll get two real high-end engineers helping me, and we'll overcomplicate the crap out of this. What do you think? Yeah, I know. You engineers will agree with me, too. I know. We're going to sink combustion chamber. The edge of the combustion chamber, we're going to sink a decomp right here and right here. We're going to use two. We're going to try to. If two doesn't do it, this is why we're probably going to re-machine heads, because we're going to screw a few up trying to get it exactly like I want, or it's going to work right out of the box. What I think is two decomps are probably going to relieve enough pressure by putting it in the head. Yeah, I know, steel's done it for years, and it works. I'm sorry, guys, but it does. And then they're not the only ones either, trust me. And them 576s, Huskies, they're in the head too, that series saw. So, no, it doesn't have no ill effects. The only thing we got to make sure is our decomp isn't sticking into our combustion chamber. We want just a hole. So, there'll probably be just a little bit of an angle. Let's just see what happens. But that may work. That may exactly work. If you got some input on what you do, yeah, we was thinking like Mako's, you know, have a little short handle, put it on the handlebar. So, you know, any of you that's ever run the old Mako's with a decomp, you just pull that. Well, your hand's right there anyway. You're pulling with your right hand on the rope. And when it fires, let it warm up a bit and then release it. That I know that worked, but that's a pretty big valve. But we could probably build something. Let's try off-the-shelf stuff. Let's keep it as simple as possible. Okay, carburation. Do we need more carburation? Let's try not to. I know what happens. We're going to get, if we start putting bigger carbs on this particular saw, like we have in some of the other ones, we're going to end up with something we don't want to run. I'm going to tell you that right now. So, I'm going to try a stock carburetor. We may drill the jets. Yes, there's more to it than just that. I know that. But I haven't let that secret out yet either. And it's not a secret. It's in all the books. Center plug. Now, if you've noticed, if I can get this out, we're not using a large plug. I think right here I got a chainsaw plug somewhere I took out right here. This is your common chainsaw plug. This is what we're using. It's much smaller. No, there's no reason. It comes with the head. I'm not going to change it. Yeah, this goes in dirt bikes too. I know. All of this goes in dirt bikes. This is not recreating the wheel. This is a wheel that's been built different. That's all it is. It's all from snowmobiles and dirt bikes, stuff like that. You remember Thursday, I told you the chainsaws were 40 years behind times on the mods. They are. And this is proof right here. It really is. But we had to do a nice job on our machine work. We didn't have a choice. We want an absolute seal. Now, what's funny about this? I want to talk to you guys about this. There are some of you guys out there smarter than I am about some things. And I know it. I'm not gonna say you ain't. That's fairly soft aluminum. Okay? I guarantee it is. It's off a darn Chinese frickin' bicycle two-stroke kit. That's not going to be real high-dollar aluminum, is it? Now, we're going to have 8mm studs running up through them holes. We're going to have chrome-plated cap screws, you know, the acorn style, that fasten the head, which has ample thickness to hold the cylinder and that on. Follow me? Can you just depend on your machining? I'm going to say I've probably in a half a thousandths is probably the most, because you can actually get this to, yeah, you hear it? It sticks. It sticks. Now there's a little shock sideways, just tiny, tiny, tiny bit. You can kind of, and it sticks. And there's like a little snap to pull it off. It's just suction. If you put a little oil on that, it'll really stick. Can we use aviation cement? Indian head shellac? Anything that was used in the old metal head gaskets from back in the day on automobiles? Would that be ample? Probably, wouldn't it? But at this point, I'm planning on a copper gasket. We might try that Indian head. We might try something like that just to see what that does. I think this is going to be fun. What do you think, Colin?
Why wouldn't it work? Everything else, that's dirt bikes and cars, everything else has got heads, and dirt bikes have reeds, snowmobiles have reeds. Why wouldn't it work?
I think the only thing we're going to have to do is just work out the tension of the reed. Yeah. How that's really what I'm thinking.
Just a little bit different timing.
Yeah, a lot different timing, actually. Projects like this is a kind of a rarity here in this shop right at this point, but, you know, we went a lot further on the weekend than we actually thought. And we got this far fairly fast. Now, we're waiting on studs. We're waiting on a few other parts that we want to use. We got, this isn't it. This is only introduction. There's way more going into this, and you're going to love it. I swear you're going to love it.
Yeah.
Especially the first fire. I'm going to give you something to think about with this saw. I'm going to give it to you. And I'll promise you, when we're done and showing you, if you can get one of these little mini lathes like we got right here, we'll show you how to build your mandrels. We'll show you how to do this. You don't have to be a machinist to do this kind of work. You got to be a machinist to do this work perfect the first time. You can do this. These little heads are about $12 on eBay, okay? That's, you got to buy these by the bag full and just chuck them. This is going to be your hardest thing to figure. I'll even show you where to cut your cylinders if you guys have a mind to do something like this. That little reed right here, this little reed cage, yep, that is actually on eBay for dirt cheap for a motorized bicycle engine kit, two-stroke. That's what it's for. Okay. It's cheap, $30. And all you got to do is you take this area right here, and you cut it off right to the bottom of that screwdriver. Right, about right in there. You cut that right off. That is just JB welded on. That's all it is. Can I use this rod? Oh, sure. Once I know what I'm wanting to do, I wanted to at least be able to get the darn thing off. But because I can come right in beside that and cut that. Or maybe heat the crap out of it and fall off probably. Okay, so with these concepts like this, I realize this is a little different, but I hope you guys will follow this build and really enjoy it. I really do. You can get a lot out of this kind of stuff. You really can. Give me a last look at that. That's it right there. It's simple. Yeah, I built that combustion chamber. That's my own design. Yeah, where'd you get that from, huh? Yep. Dirt bikes. Snowmobiles. Alrighty.